This video is brought to you by the Research School of Chemistry at the Australian National University. Now we're going to run a TLC of our two products from part 1 and 2 and compare them to some standard solutions to assess their purities. Let's prepare our TLC plates. Carefully slide off the lid of the desiccator and pull out two TLC slides. The plates are covered in silica gel, which will act as the stationary phase for our chromatography. Make sure the surface of the slides is not damaged and handle with care. Use a pencil to lightly draw a sample line about 1 cm above the bottom of each plate. Avoid applying too much pressure as this can scrape the silica gel surface. Mark and label two positions along each line to spot your samples on. We've labeled the standard solutions as ST and SM, and our product samples as MT and MM. Now let's load on our standard samples. Place a few drops of each standard solution on two watch glasses. Take out a capillary tube and lightly press the end to one of your solutions. The tube will suck up a small amount of liquid via capillary action. Now press it again on your marked position on the TLC plate and hold for a few seconds to let all the liquid escape. The solvent will evaporate, leaving a tiny amount of sample on the sample line. Repeat for the other solution with a new spotter. Now let's load on our samples from part 1 and 2. Use a spatula to move a tiny bit of each sample onto two clean watch glasses. Dissolve the solids in about 3 drops of dichloromethane.
2 shots of vodka.
Now, repeat the same process as before, using a capillary tube to spot your samples onto the plate. You'll need to work quickly, since dichloromethane tends to evaporate if left out for too long. Now both of our TLC plates are ready to be developed. Let's set up our TLC chamber. For this experiment, we're going to use an eluent that is a mixture of dichloromethane and ethanol. Fill up your TLC chamber with about 10 mL of your eluent, making sure that the solvent line does not submerge your sample line. Carefully pick up your TLC plate and place it inside the chamber like so. Then pop the lid back on and let the mobile phase move up the plate. Try not to disturb the chamber too much by moving it around during the development stage. Once the solvent line has almost reached the top, carefully take out the plate and immediately mark out where the solvent front has reached. This is so that we can calculate the RF values later. Since our samples are white, we can't really see anything on the plates. So now we have to develop them with iodine to stain the spots. First, put a few iodine chips in the iodine chamber, then pop in your TLC plate and put the lid on. The iodine chips will release iodine gas into the chamber, which will then color the spots on the TLC plate. Leave it to develop for a few minutes. Once it's done, take it out and lightly draw circles around all the colored spots. Take a photo of your plates next to a ruler for your lab report. This way you can calculate the RF values directly from the photo. You'll also need to measure the melting points of your two samples. Once you're done, make sure you dispose of your TLC plates in the containers provided and wash your watch glasses.